And I'm interested, if you can't talk specifically about the deal, what did you learn about where the market is?
Yeah, look, I think let's talk about where the market is. And you know, I think there's been a lot of IPO supply over the last several weeks to months. It's generally been very well absorbed in the market. It's generally been very well bid. I think when you look at that, you really want to look at the components of that. And what's really gone very well are some of the technology offerings that have had a real scarcity of supply over several years. And so looking through the market, I think you're seeing varying degrees of price sensitivity or discipline across the different sectors in the market.
What's affecting the IPO market? And I'll give you two alternatives. One is volatility. We often hear that increased volatility actually is not a friend of IPOs. On the other hand, search for yield. People actually have a lot of cash they need to put somewhere.
Yeah, if you take a look at inflows this year, I mean, volatility has come down. You know, it went up in the beginning of the year. It's been on a downward trend. It's down to about 13 right now.
So that's helpful.
That's been supportive of the IPO market the last several weeks. If you look at inflows, inflows at mutual funds have actually been quite modest over the last 2 months, whereas they were strong in the first portion of the year. So I think what you're seeing is that the broad market, people are looking at the calendar as a way to get product they haven't been able to get. A lot of that product has been more technology or other driven that's been absent from the calendar.
So going forward, where are we going to see the more IPOs? Where are we going to see the more secondaries? Where do you think activity is going to pick up?
Well, you've seen a lot of secondaries this year in the utility sector. That I'd say would be a departure from the past. Equity and equity-like securities out of utilities are probably approaching $10 billion this year. I think that probably exceeds the last 2 to 3 years combined. And that may be counterintuitive. The utilities have underperformed pretty meaningfully since December. They were obviously on the back, on the losing side of tax reform and on the losing side of rate increases. But the market, I think, has priced in the need for equity, and these transactions are generally getting done very, very well.
Can you talk about the quality of the companies? I mean, are these like the big guys with killer balance sheets that are coming in? Are these the smaller players that have more risk?
Yeah, I think you're seeing it across the industry. So, you know, tax reform on the corporate level has had a lot of winners. Mm-hmm. On the utility side, it's actually increased the need for equity. It's counterintuitive. And so you're seeing it really across the spectrum. So you're seeing very high quality issuers come to market that have underperformed by 12 to 15% over the course of 6 months. And you're seeing more than ample appetite to provide equity into the utility group.